The floor is covered. I got one sticking to me. I'm sweaty and man, that it was just fun. It was just fun. So on today's video, I'm gonna talk about how I became an erotic dancer and basically my journey leading up to where I am now. I do plan on making a video on how to become an erotic dancer or stripper or entertainer, whatever you would like to call yourself. All right, so let's get into this video. How I became an erotic dancer. So for me, I wouldn't say I've always been a dancer. I do like to dance. I've never been to any dance classes. I haven't took dance. Everything has really been pretty much just been freestyle for the most part. So more so specifically as far as seductive grinding dancing, I have been doing that since I was like 15, 16. I don't know why I gravitated towards it, probably because like I'm more of a hypersexual person, but that definitely was always my favorite form of dancing or self-expression in dance. Literally, I would be in my room looking up YouTube videos on anybody grinding. Usually it'll be those board, like about five guys in a living room all humping the couch. Those videos I was definitely watching, but I started leaning more towards masculine dancers and just really any type of entertainers that were actually in a club or at a party, just working the floor, working the crowd, doing their routines. And I really just fell in love with it. But yeah, nah, it would definitely be a whole range of different types of humans that would be dirty dancing. And then I definitely was always practicing in my room. I would be in front of the mirror, you know, winding the hips and doing my body rolls and also recording myself just to make sure, you know, I looked good. I wasn't sending it to nobody really, probably like my significant others at the time. But yeah, no, I really just kind of recorded myself grinding, you know, for myself just to see where I could do better at and how my roles look and just how everything looks. Mind you, I was still in high school, so 15 to 18, I was on YouTube all the time. I know a couple of great OGs that I followed throughout the years that I still follow now. Shout out to the masculine dancers that I definitely watched growing up. King Kells, Pretty P, Carter the Body. Oh, she's so fun. Those top three, I was steady studying, steady watching them. And of course, eventually I had stumbled across City of Dawns on YouTube. So all of their dancers, they traveled across the East Coast, seeing them, always wanting to be there and dance with them and getting the opportunity. So yeah, I definitely looked up the City of Dawns as well. So in college, I started wilding out, okay? You hear me? I started wilding out at the parties. I remember my first party, I had dipped down and started stroking the ground, and I jumped on my friend and started grinding on her. And from there, it just got worse. It just got worse. Literally, any party that I had went to, 9 times out of 10, when grind time hit, when it's just a whole little section of sex songs and grinding songs, yeah. I'm on the floor somewhere. Somebody find me, please. Yeah, nah, it had got to a point where my friends knew, like, if my song comes on, if you're next to me, I'm bending you over and I'm doing what I do, or I'm picking you up, I'm putting you on the table. And it got like that. I'll say I've always had that confidence in grinding. Like, it's just something that I love to do. Like, it's just something that is very fun for me. And I can't really say, like, I had to build a confidence because I already had it in me. So when I had got to college, it was up and stuck. And by this time on camp, it was already kind of getting known that I was the one that was grinding at the parties. And usually if you see a video of a girl doing something on the floor, 9 times out of 10, it was me. I was always dancing. I was always doing something at parties, but I definitely had my fun. I definitely had my fun, child. But yeah. My freshman year of college, I had joined a modeling troupe called FAME. FAME stands for Fashion Above Modern Expression. So it was basically like Vogue dancing. And and model stance. So of course the modeling troupe consisted of males and females. And when I tried out, I was dancing with the women. So I'm wearing my heels, I'm pumping, I'm doing my twists and turns in my heels, and I'm doing more feminine movements and poses. All that was cool. I loved it. I loved every second of it. I will say I didn't make too many routines that fall semester. But yeah, it's okay. So spring semester had came around and I had started dancing with the guys. It was one day the choreographers had came in and they had showed us the dances that we would be doing for the next showcase. And I had saw the male dances and I was like, I want to do that. Y'all grinding. I want to grind too. Let me go practice with y'all for a day. See if I can, you know, do this. They all was cool with it. They all had no problems. You know, I just went over there and I started practicing with them. All of Ebor was okay with me switching over to the guys, and you know, it wasn't no complaints or no problems there. So I switched over to dancing with the guys. So that meant real hype routines, and then that meant sexy routines. 9 times out of 10, sexy routines, we were grinding. Then we got the grind at the showcase on stage. Count me in, please. That spring semester, I had danced with the guys. I was practicing with the guys. I had did more showcases, being more of a masculine presenting me rather than feminine me. So I didn't have to wear heels. I definitely just wore sneakers or loafers or whatever the outfits had consisted of at the time. So at the end of the year, for any people who had just joined Fame, they all get a Fame name. So a Fame name was basically something that describes their personality or how they are in practice or how their work ethic is or just their overall being. So because I danced with the guys and because I was always showing my behind in practice, literally every chance I got, I was showing my behind in practice, they had gave me the Fame name of Pretty Nasty. So that's how Pretty Nasty came alive. That's how Pretty Nasty came about. And yeah. So it was fall 19 when I had became the male choreographer for Fame. I was creating all the routines. I was creating any hype routines, sexy routines, with the help of others, of course. And yeah, that was the time of my life. So me being male choreographer, best believe any sexy routine, it was going to be set. We was doing something, okay? We was doing something, grinding on the floor, in the chair. We was doing something, okay? I had been dancing with Fame for like 4 to 5 years. So all of the showcases that we had in the semester, I was on stage grinding. Of course, with the hype routines as well, but any sexy routine that they was having, yeah, I was there. So once COVID had became a thing, we couldn't be on campus. There weren't any showcases. There wasn't any social gatherings. So we couldn't really, you know, have a showcase, put on a show, perform. Over the years, I had been following City of Doms and I had saw that they was going to be in Atlanta. It was going to be in Atlanta March of 2022. So I just started thinking, I was like, Atlanta is not too far away from me. I'm in North Carolina, so Atlanta is not too far of a drive, honestly. I hit up the page and I was like, hey, how do I go about being an entertainer with you all? And they had told me I had to contact the boss. So if you know City of Doms is an all-lesbian group ran by a man. I didn't have a problem with it and I wasn't really concerned about it because I was just trying to think about me and how do I put myself into this industry. So yeah, it wasn't really bothersome to me. So I had hit him up and he had asked, you know, where am I from? How far am I from ATL? At the time I was like 7 hours away. So then he was like, if you're serious, you know, come meet the team in ATL. The next day he had called me up on the phone and he was saying that when you come to ATL, you will be eye candy and that you will be giving lab dances as well as serving drinks. I was like, okay, you know, I can do that. I can definitely give the lap dances. And I mean, I can be a eye candy. That's no problem. Going into it, I know I wasn't going to be in the lineup. I know I wasn't going to have like a set time to perform. That would be my first time dancing for people who knew what they were coming to come see. And also tip. I was just like, yeah, no, I've never been to a City of Doms event. I'm more than okay than just being eye candy, doing lap dances and everything, because really I was just going to gather everything that I saw and just kind of put it into my own little spin. And then eventually I would be able to start, you know, doing my own performances my way. When it was official, I had started promoting. I started saying, you know, pull up the ATL, City of Doms, I'm a beater, da da da, come see the show, whatever. Heavy promotion, okay? Heavy promotion. March 2022 came, drove to ATL, got me a place to stay at for the night. When I tell y'all, like, that was the best first to get Dom's experience ever. Like, it was crazy. I was meeting everybody on the team. I was meeting everybody that I had saw on social media, on YouTube. So this is my first show. This is my first scenery of any lesbian entertainer events. So I'm hyped. I didn't know what specifically to wear for any lap dances or just to be eye candy. I just chose sports bra. I chose, it was either boxers or spandex. I had my knee pads. I had some red shoes because it was the boss lady's birthday, so we had to throw in a hint of red. The hair was done. The hair was in 2-strand twists, you know. So yeah, no, I was looking good, okay? Tattoos just sitting on the skin, body glistening. I felt like I looked good, feel me? So yeah, no, the show started. Everybody started, you know, doing their lineups. And then there was moments where I definitely got to give lap dances. Those weren't hard at all. It was real fun for me. It was real fun to be in that experience and also get tipped for the first time. It was a crazy experience. If I could tell y'all behind the scenes of that whole trip. Bruh. Throughout the night, I'm giving lap dances. I'm being eye candy. I ain't even gonna lie. I didn't serve too many drinks. Probably served like 2-3, but nah, for the most part I was in somebody's face, okay? I was in somebody's face. And then I'm watching all the performance as well, and I'm just like, okay, like I see the energy that they give, I see the moves that they're doing, I see how they connect with their crowd, I see how they connect with the audience. And mentally, I'm taking notes, I'm jotting down, I'm like, okay, this is what I want to do for my performance, this is what I want to have, this is what I want to wear, just visualizing everything that I want to do for my performance. As the night kept going on, I kept getting tipped, I was dancing with the dancers, we had a couple of nice little bags split 3 ways, 2 ways, whoever I danced with, honestly. At one point, literally, it was me and 2 other dancers. Shout out to Honey and Lovely. I definitely love meeting y'all. But literally, we was just in the middle of the floor and I had laid down. One of them was on top of me. One of them was on the bottom. And then they was just shaking and bouncing. And, you know, I'm just grabbing and reaching. I didn't see anything but ass, dollars, and lights in my face. Like, that was the scenery. That was what was going on. It felt really good to interact with the other dancers as well, like as far as grinding with them and dancing with them and picking them up. And you know, of course, you gotta sell a show. You have to sell a show to make the money. So, and I feel like that's what I definitely did with them. But after that first show, I was like, yeah, I'm coming back. When's the next show? Okay. The next show, I believe, was in New York, so I was not gonna be able to make that one. I didn't have the funds for a flight, and I didn't feel like, you know, that was going to work out best for me. The next show was Baltimore, July 2022. In between the time of March and July, it was definitely promotion. And I had used any clips that I had from the March show, and I just promoted those heavy throughout that time period. Saying like, oh, you know, I'm going to be in Baltimore. These are the dates. Pull up and see me. Come tip me. And just keeping that heavy, repetitive promotion up until July. So for the Baltimore show in July, I was gonna be in the lineup. And at this point, I'm geeked. I'm like, okay, bet. I have to get my outfit figured out. I have to get my music figured out. I have to figure out, you know, what moves I'm gonna give and what sequence and figuring out how I'm gonna work the crowd. Of course, I was confident in my dancing. I just didn't know how to give confidence during my performance. And I say it like that because I didn't know how to give a confident stage presence to where I could go from interacting with this person into a smooth transition into interacting with the next person or just doing whatever moves next. And it was stuff like that that I kind of was having, I was a little fuzzy about. Like, I didn't know how it was gonna look. I didn't know how it was gonna, you know, pan out. Literally from March to July, I'm practicing in the living room. I'm practicing 2 different songs. I'm practicing different music in front of the mirror, of course. And at the time, there was a pole in the living room, so I was using that to my advantage as well. Literally, whenever I could, it was practice, practice, practice. I wanted to go out and give a great first performance and give a great first impression. So for my outfit, I had settled on a black cap with pretty on it in pink, a black sports bra, black pants that I had painted nasty on the back. Then I had planned on wearing a big black overall jacket that during the performance I was gonna zip off and, you know, throw to the crowd. Also was wearing a pink bandana and a pink thong. For my first song, it was Under the Influence. My second song was Do Not Disturb by Teyana Taylor. Third song was Drop and Give Me 50. My last song was Skin by Rihanna, I believe. I had drove up to Baltimore the day of the show. I had got settled into where I was going to be staying at, you know, showered up and everything. Headed to the club, and I was just sitting there until it was time to get the show started and time for me to perform. When it's time to get the show started, he had put me first up. I said, bro. Which, I mean, it honestly makes sense because, you know, I'm the newest one. I have the less experience. I don't really have a fan base anywhere. So, yeah, put me first. I'm getting dressed and I'm just getting nervous. I took about a shot or two right before just to calm myself down. I was like, man, them nerves was crazy. I was just more so nervous on not messing anything up and not getting stuck and not looking like a deer in headlights. I'm backstage and people hyping me up. Shout out to the real Gemini because she was sitting here telling me like, look, when you go out there, your energy needs to be up here. You need to be the only and the baddest motherfucker in the building. Like, this is your stage. These are your people. Show them a good time. The pep talk is getting me going, you know. So he started saying an introduction for me. Then he called out my name. Then my music started playing. I'm like, boy. I started walking out and I'm just like, come on. Just pretty nasty. Pretty nasty. Get nasty. You calm down. You good. So my music starts going. And, you know, I'm doing a little bit of movements and stuff like that. I'm low-key getting stuck because I'm just like, man, I'm not used to this. And then it also didn't help because I wasn't familiar with the club setting and how it was set up. So basically it was a pole and a walkway in the middle. You had the bar coming around the pole and the walkway. And then you had another walkway that was on the outside with people sitting on the sides. I'm just going through the aisle and I'm going in between people sitting down and in between people like sitting at the bar. I'm just trying to make little movements. I'm trying to, you know, be smooth with it and everything. Mind you, I still had on my jacket. One thing that I did not account for is like how long I would be dancing with my jacket on, because in my mind, when the song goes, make you tattoo my name on it, that's when I was gonna pull the jacket off, right? But that's like in the second part of the song. So I was low-key dancing and doing some body movements with the jacket on, and like people's not here for that. Definitely a lesson learned. When it came time for me to actually pull off the jacket, you know, it felt like I was a little bit more in tune. Nobody was tipping me at this moment, I will say that. That's when I had walked around the bar, and then my second song had came on. So I was like, all right, the jacket off, time to get real seductive, real, you know, show them the body. I saw this one chick, and I'm just like, all right, you staring at me, and I'm looking at you, bet you're first. She started a little bit of money on me. Probably out of sympathy, honestly, because nobody else was throwing shit. So then I kind of like teased her a little bit. I had like, you know, moved in on her, moved back, whatever. And then I started grinding. I started doing little hip movements. From there, I was like, okay, so now time to act up. Started walking over it, and then I had seen some peoples that I had knew. I climbed on top of her. I was grinding on her. And then I started making my way down a little bit more. Then my song had switched up again. So I had went back to the front of the bar. I had literally stood on top of the bar and I started twerking to Drop and Give Me 50. I literally dropped down and gave him 50 while twerking. Please. Now people are hype. People are throwing dollars. You know, they like what they see. I said, bet. All right, we good. Just no nerves. I'm all right now. I'll say halfway through my performance, there was no nerves. Everything just felt natural to me. Everything just felt like you already know what you're doing. So just do it. This is what you was practicing for. This was what you wanted to do. So go out and do it. And I did it. Afterwards, I felt really good. I was like, all right, you know, the nerves is gone. I have nothing to be nervous about, actually. So let's just keep this in mind for the next performance. Switching to my second outfit. And then I started giving lap dances and helping the other dancers pick up their money. The rest of the night was pretty smooth. I had ended up meeting another dancer. Her name was Vanity J. Poles. That girl is fine, okay? My girl is a thickums, okay? She's like a BBW. Like, she a thickums. And like, ooh, child. From that Baltimore show, we have became cool. And she wanted me to come back to Baltimore the next month and dance at her birthday. Knowing me, I'm like, yup. Let's go. I'm down. Let's get it. So the City of Dom show was in July. Her birthday show was in August. Prior to the Baltimore show, I had did a mini photo shoot with one of my friends on camp. Literally, I just wanted a couple of pictures for promo and to have like a nice little cutout for flyers if needed. So I had put rollers in my hair and curled my hair. I had a little outfit with me, something simple. I wasn't trying to, you know, go all out. And we literally went to the student center stairwell. We had went to one of the back staircases and it was just a blank wall. And that's all I really needed. I didn't need a backdrop. I just wanted a blank wall. Literally standing there, he's just taking pictures of me and I ain't gonna hold you. A couple of people did come down the stairs, look at me. And I was just like, mind your business. So from that mini photo shoot, I had a couple of good raw pictures of me looking sexy, and I was able to use those pictures to promote for Vanity's birthday show. And then I had also wanted to take a couple of videos of me just dancing and grinding, so I had ended up going to the rec center. I had on one of my outfits and I had different videos recorded of me just grinding in different positions, different ways to different songs, just so I can get a different beat and a different tempo in my rhythm and my body movements. So with the pictures from my photo shoot and the videos that I had recorded, I had sent a couple of them to Vanity and she had made the dopest little flyer for me for her birthday. I said, yes, ma'am. August came around and it was time for her birthday and we were back at Baltimore and ironically back at the same club as well. So I had my music set, I had my outfit set. So literally it was just time to perform and you know, it was all good. Unfortunately, I didn't get to do my set, but I did have the opportunity to record different videos of me just dancing, grinding, and use them for personal promo and other business promo. After her birthday show in August, at this point, I was just promoting for the next Call of Duty event. Call of Duty. I was promoting for City of Doms. Their next event was November in ATL. So at that point, I was just promoting for them. And I was also working out, doing other little things that I needed to do to, you know, become better. So October 2022, I had got invited out to New York to go dance. Shout out to Body Hunter and Ivy for the opportunity. I had met them through another dancer who I had met in ATL back in March. Yeah, invited me to her show in Baltimore that was back in April. And then we had drove up to New York to see Body and Ivy's performance. Performing at an event called Gush. Gush, I absolutely fell in love with when I first went back in April. I fell in love with the atmosphere. I fell in love with the people. I fell in love with the music. It was really like a different rave type of setting. Everybody who was anybody could come out. Didn't matter if you was gay, straight, trans, queer, black, white, Korean, however you looked, however you expressed yourself, you can come out. So literally it was an event full of different people, different types of people, different ethnicities, different backgrounds, different styles, and I was in love there. You could wear what you wanted to wear. So if you wanted your titties out, your titties was out. And it was such a great spot that like it was very much a no judgment zone. At least on a dance floor, you couldn't record. You couldn't have your phone out. You couldn't, you know, it wasn't no like a no phone zone basically. So you really could just be in the moment with the music and just having fun and dance however you want to, express yourself however you want to. And it was a great experience. At Gush, I saw Body and Ivy's performance and they were amazing. Gush was having another event in October and Body and Ivy, they were going to be performing again. So Body had hit me up and she was like, hey, you know, do you want to perform at Gush? Like, are you down? And I'm just seeing her like, absolutely, please. This was a week before the show. All of my expenses was paid for, so literally all I had to do was just show up. It being October, we had went with a Halloween theme. Me and Body basically were the prisoners or the inmates, and then Ivy, she was the sexy police officer. So we had got the jumpsuits, we had got it made. I put Pretty on mine, I put Body on hers, put Property of Gush on the back. Yeah, nah, that setup was fire. Okay, day of the event came, I had got dropped off at the airport flew out to New York, landed, got checked into my hotel, which was actually right down the street from where the event was gonna be at. Chilled for a couple of hours, grabbed some food, met up with Body and Ivy, and we was just catching up and started talking. And then we started talking about the performance and what, you know, we was gonna do and what would look good. Took my good old 30-minute shower, then I got dressed and it was time to head over there. Pulled up to the event and literally it was just the same atmosphere that I had, you know, first felt back in April. It was amazing. Vibes was dope. The atmosphere was dope. The event, the place we was at this time, it was real cool. We had an upstairs and downstairs, and of course it was like two different music genres going on and different, you know, atmosphere going on. And I'm talking about, it's one of those events where like you would see people on the side just kissing. Like I'm talking about almost about to. Okay, it's like one of the, like, it's a great place to just go, let loose, mind your business, and just have fun. So boom, we was finna perform. We had went to the bag, we got changed. Me and Body, we was wearing the orange jumpsuit, and for me, I had on like a white strap body piece, red boxers, and yeah, I think that was it. I was wearing a thong as well, and a white beater, just to give off, you know, the inmate look. How Gush and Body and Ivy like to set up their performances. Basically, it's just a ring of chairs around the floor. So whoever is sitting in the chair, you gotta throw money. If you're sitting in the chair, you're throwing money. You're getting a dance, you're throwing money. Once we, you know, broke off and was doing our own little dances, I just looked to the first person who was in the chair. I just started crawling to him and just sat in their lap, started grinding. I was just doing so many moves. It was crazy. And then it was like a red light. So that was even perfect because it just set the mood for the entire time. Hitting one move on one person and then boom, I go to this chair and I'm hitting this move on that and on that person. Then I'm coming to the middle and I'm dancing with the dancers. Really, I was dancing everywhere. I was dancing with them. Clothes was being took off. Shoes was everywhere. I couldn't find one of my tens for the longest on the floor. I couldn't find my boxers anywhere at one point. Night was so crazy. I'm talking like we're literally rolling in money. Like the floor is covered in ones. When I tell you the people of Gush in New York showed mad love, they showed love, okay? The floor is covered. I got one sticking to me. I'm sweaty and man, that it was just fun. It was just fun. So then after that, we had wiped down, changed into another outfit, and then we was just gonna give lap dances for the rest of the night. All of the money had got picked up from the floor, and you know, we carried it back to the hotel. And all of it got split three ways as well. So, you know, my cut was very beautiful. Then that next day, I'm on a flight back to North Carolina. So that was that. From the show in October, going into November, I'm just still promoting heavy for the next COD event. Next event was gonna be in ATL, so everything was already planned out. I already knew I was good to go. In the meantime, I'm promoting, I'm posting, I'm working out, I'm working on my moves. I'm just making sure everything looked good, you know. I had to get my outfit together and I had to get my music together again. This was gonna be my second solo performance. So my song choices, I had chose Distance off of P-Valley, Birthday Cake by Rihanna because I wanted to throw a twerking song in there. Damn, what was the other two songs? Control Me by Van Jess and then Morning by Teyana Taylor and Kalani. So that was my set list. And then for my outfit, I had on a pink long sleeve shirt that eventually I was gonna take off, a pink utility vest, regular jeans, my knee pads, a pink bandana, and it was tied to my belt loop. I forgot what boots I wore. I forgot what shoes I wore. I think they were tan though. I know they're tan. And of course, a pink thong. Once again, I was first in the lineup. I hated being first, but you know, it is what it is. But this time around, my baby, she had came with me to this show. So this was her first time seeing me perform. And then also a chance to like really give her a lap dance in that setting. Cause I already had gave her lap dances before, but this was the first time like, you know, giving her a lap dance at an actual event. Back in ATL, we got ready. We had went to the event. So we was just chilling. Went backstage, started getting ready. I wasn't as nervous as I was before the other times I had performed. And that was always a good feeling for me. Of course, I still had like a little bit of jitters, but already knew that like I was gonna go out there and kill it, so I was good. Went out there, my first couple of moves, I just didn't know what to do, but you know, I prospered through it all, and I made a good little show for myself. Baby was there recording the whole time, so that's how I got some good videos. Thank you, baby. So that was that show. Definitely still had a great time seeing, you know, everybody there. And that would be the last show of 2022 that I did. In January, I wanted to do another photo shoot. I wanted to do an updated photo shoot just for any personal promo and any other flyer promos that I would be doing, you know, eventually. My baby, she has this friend, her name's Bonnie. Shout out to Bonnie. She had took my pictures for me in front of a backdrop. I only did one outfit, only did one look, because that's really all I wanted to get us to start with. But them photos came out dope. Okay, them photos was like that. Of course, from then I had used those photos for promo. I used it for promo. I had sent it to whoever was gonna need a flyer and have them put on the flyer, and boom. Heading into the new year, 2023, I had a friend tell me about this place called the Life Lounge, and it was in Baltimore, and that I should hit up the owner and see what's up. The Life Lounge is basically a LGBTQ strip club, has lesbian dancers, gay dancers, whatever type of dancers, male, female, transsexual dancers, anybody who is some type of under the rainbow and wanted to dance, they were there. So I had DM'd the owner and I was like, hey, do you need any more entertainers? I would love to come out and perform, you know, da da da. And she was saying, how old are you? Where are you from? All that. Because I was in North Carolina and I had to drive to Baltimore, I didn't have to pay a tip in, which I definitely appreciate her for. Shout out to Poetry Pose of Poetry in Motion, Life Lounge. You're doing your thing. So yeah, I was set to come to their next Life Lounge event, which was every third Saturday. So it was the third Saturday in February of 2023. Now for this performance, this would be my first time doing a strip club rotation. Before, I was used to just being on a performer rotation where it was just the first one, the second one, third one, and then that was it. Of course, the strip club rotation, it was that you have five dancers and then those five dancers dance again. So just in that rotation. So like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that was gonna be my first experience doing that. Of course, I seen it when I had went to strip clubs, but to actually be in it, I was like, okay, this is gonna be a little change up. So with that being said, I was able to basically perform twice in one night. Driving up to Baltimore once again with my baby, she had came with me. Stepping into the club, it was definitely a different atmosphere. I was like, oh, this is nice. Well, they had the stage and then they had the room set up kind of like around them basically. And then the upstairs was the dressing rooms. Middle of the stage was three poles. They was all static. And then at the top, they all kind of like looped together so that you could climb on the top and do whatever tricks and flips you wanted to do up there. Getting there and meeting the dancers, I had fell in love with them already. Everybody had a great energy to them. Everybody had a great vibe to them. Everybody was real cool, real calm, real collected. Yeah, nah, we was just gonna have a great night. I already knew I was gonna have a pretty good night. The energy felt good, so I was just like, you know, I'm gonna just sit back and let this thing happen. I already picked out my songs, but the DJ wasn't cooperating with nobody and he just wanted to be on his own type of time, so I had got my songs picked for me, basically. And I told him, I was like, if that's how you want to be, that's cool. I need something nasty and slow. I can't do fast, I can't do hype. Nasty and slow. Boom. The first song this man plays is Under the Influence. I said, we here. First song was Under the Influence. My second song was All We Do by Trey Songz, which was a great follow-up song. For the outfit choice, I actually wore this black spandex type shirt, and I had it like this, but then I eventually like rolled it up to, you know, show somebody as well. And then I had on this same harness. This is one of my favorite black harnesses. Then I had on some black mesh Playboy shorts, my knee pads, my black Tims. The hair was in twists, so you already know. Now also, when I perform, I like to wear gloves just so I feel like I have a better grip and I just have a sense of like what my hands are doing. I'm on stage. Of course, I don't have nothing set in my mind. I just planned on going on stage and doing whatever felt right. I really love to feed off of people's energy whenever they see me perform or if I have somebody in front of me watching me perform. And it just makes it easier for me to like know my next move, or know if like I want to pull them in or pick them up or grab them by their neck. And you know, it's easy for me to read people through my body language. So, which makes my performances feel real good. I'm working the stage, I'm messing with the people who's sitting in the chairs, and then eventually I get off the stage and I kind of like walk around in the crowd. Then I just get back on stage and just grinded the rest of the songs away, or just was doing my own little thing until the next song ended. I went back upstairs and I had changed into my second outfit, regular jeans, gray thong, gray sports bra. Definitely wore my Tims. I wore my pink bunny ear hat. It was a cute little simple nice look. I really loved the look. So in between my sets, I'm downstairs, I'm messing with my baby, I'm watching everybody else dance, I'm tipping the other dancers as well. They all very talented, okay? Especially to be on a static pole and to be able to do the tricks and turns that they did. I said, yeah, kudos to you, because I need a turning pole for me. Like, I can't do static poles, personally. Then it was time for me to do my second set. DJ, he was like, you know, I'm on my own type of time, I'm just playing music. I was like, all right, sexy and slow, nasty and slow, come on, give it to me. Started walking down the stairs, started getting ready. First song he played was Hours and Hours. I said, okay, I could do this. I had worked that song and I had made it do what it do. I did a good couple of moves, especially with somebody sitting down in the chair and kind of like me climbing into their lap and, you know, yeah. By this time, it was more people in the club, so I had attention on me. Definitely had people who were very dope who came to see me. So the second song he played for my second set was If I Get Caught by Division. I've listened to Division, but I've never heard this song. This was my first time ever hearing this song. And this is my first time hearing this song while I'm on stage dancing to it. I'm just like, okay, just feel the beat, just feel the music, and you know. So before my second set, I had met this young lady who had said she had drove to come see me perform, and that she was kind of nervous and this was kind of like new to her. So I was like, okay, so let's keep her in mind because I want to show her a good time, especially since she drove out to come see me. The second song started and then I had got done doing another dance for the last song. Got up on stage and I had walked over to Shorty. I'm on stage, so she's on the ground. I just literally grab her by her neck and just kind of like jump down and use her as in a way as support. So I started dancing on her. I started dancing with her. I remember I had turned her around, you know, I started thrusting. Started grinding on her from the back, and then I had pulled out one of my tricks. This is why I say practice makes perfect. Practice, practice, practice. I pulled out one of my tricks that I had been wanting to do. Of course, I had seen it from YouTube from one of the mass entertainers. I had her bent over, and then basically I had did a somersault to flip myself upside down, but also on top of her to where I was still thrusting, to where I was still grinding on her as well. So I did that for a couple of counts, and it's funny that I did not know the song at all because I hit it perfectly on beat. The way that I thrusted, the way that I grinded and I hit the beat, it was perfect, especially since I did not know this song at all. From there, of course, I'm upside down. I see ankles and legs. I had really quick kind of like pushed myself off the ground to wrap my legs around her thighs and throw my body over. When I go down, she's gonna pull down with me. Once we're on the floor, she's laying on top of me and her legs are in the air. And then from there, I just flipped her over and then started grinding again. At this point, I'm tired. I'm tired, and I'm just like, dang, when is this song going to end? Kept doing a couple of ending moves, and then song was over, thankfully, and then I was done. In between both sets, I was still doing lap dances as well, and, you know, meeting people, talking to people. Took pictures, got Instagrams, and yeah, it was a great night. It was a great night. The next time I went to Life Lounge was that next month in March. For that show, I only got to do one set, but it was still absolutely so fun. My first song was 24 Hours by DC Young Fly, and then my second song was Wet Dreams by 7th Streeter and Jeremiah. Unfortunately, it had hit 2 a.m. before I could do my second set, so the club was closing. And I was very upset because I already knew what I had wanted to do. It was going to look dope. But I had just waited until the next time I had went to do that second set. The third time I had went to Life Lounge, once again, it was still a great experience. Once again, it was so fun for me. Now, mind you, this is the third performance. I've had people from the first performance show up to the second, and then from the second show up to the third. So it has just, like, the clientele, my supporters, they have been amazing with coming to see me whenever I'm up there. And I love y'all for that, and I just love it. So my songs for my first set, I did Drip by Anne-Marie and Jeremiah. My second song was Wild Side by Normani and Cardi B. So for this outfit, I was going for a bunny look. Unfortunately, I had left my bunny ears back in North Carolina. I had brought the tail, but I didn't bring the bunny ears. So I improvised and I made my hair into bunny ears. I had wore a gray sports bra, gray thong, a bunny tail clipped to the back of the thong, gray shorts, pink socks, and then all white boots. So I feel like I definitely gave a bunny look, you know. So that first set, definitely fun. It's always fun when I get to dance. I mean, that's just what I'm gonna say every single time. Now my second set of the night was the set that I had wanted to do that previous time I had went to Life Lounge, but I wasn't able to do it. But this time, child. For my second set, I had did a black mesh hooded crop, studded horseshoe pasties, red boxers, black leather shorts, of course my knee pads as always, of course my hand gloves as always, black socks, and my Tims. The songs that I had chose for my second set was Unholy by Sam Smith and You by Belly featuring Kalani. So I was definitely going for a more harder, seductive look and feel for my second performance. It gave the right amount of dominating and masculine and edgy feel to it. And of course, baby was there. Of course, my baby was there. What? Please. That girl is literally my manager and my videographer every single time I go anywhere for my performances. She is the best cameraman. Woman. So I'm still currently dancing at Life Lounge. My next Life Lounge appearance would be June 24th, I believe, for Pride. Very excited about that. I haven't even started planning on what songs or what outfits I want to do yet, but just come out anyway. I'm gonna surprise myself, honestly, and yeah, let's have a good time. And then for my next performance, I will be dancing in Miami. There's a festival called Magic City Miami. It's an all-girls festival for women who love women. So it's 5 days in Miami. It's a 5-day festival of all women, all girls. I'm so excited. I already know it's gonna be crazy. I already know it's gonna be wild. And it's in Miami. Please. I had contacted them back in January about if they needed any dancers, and they was like, yeah, just email us, da da da. Signed my contract and I was good to go. I will be there performing at the Wet Her pool party. Skin gonna be out. We gonna have all the performances going at this pool party. Definitely have some more tricks up my sleeve and some things in the works as far as my next performances and my next events that I will be attending. Definitely check my social media to make sure what cities I will be going to next and what those dates are. And if you want me in your city to dance, if you want me in your city to dance at any event that you might want to go to, anything, please make sure you go to your LGBT promoters. If you see somebody having a pride event, any gay lesbian event in your city, contact them. Tell them, hey, there's this girl who's dancing and I feel like y'all should have her at y'all event to dance and, you know, bring more people out. Send them my profile, okay? Tell them to hit me up. Tell them to contact me. Tell them to email me. I can't dance in any city without y'all. You want me in your city, you have to help me. I don't know every single promoter out there. I don't know every single event that's going on. Only y'all know that's in y'all city. So if y'all see something that y'all want me to be at or y'all just want me in your city, tell them to hit me up. And then from there, we'll make something work. See if I can get out there. If you need me for any private bookings, definitely email me. Make sure you send me if it's going to be residential or if it's going to be an event. Let me know how many people. Let me know the special occasion. If it's a birthday, divorce party, bachelorette party, any type of private booking that you want to do, you can definitely hit me up and then we can set all of that up. Well, that's really it for my journey of becoming an erotic dancer. I hope you all liked the video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Subscribe. Let me know in the comments what other videos that you would love me to do. Definitely will have a how to become a erotic dancer video coming up soon. I'll definitely have the tips, the tricks, things that I've learned over the months, and just anything to help y'all become successful. Make sure y'all telling y'all promoters about me too. I'm trying to come to y'all city. I'm trying to meet y'all, and I'm trying to give y'all performances and lap dances that you could dream of. So come on, help me help y'all. All right, y'all, that's it for this video. I hope y'all have a good day, and I'll see y'all later.